as we get set for this three-way. Here comes Caleb Jean Cartier from Culture Shock.
The Mountain Tea get up in full effect. The Canadian trapper himself making his way, looking to carve his name into Inspire's legacy.
And well, I'll give CJC a little bit. He at least he gets all my Letter Kenny references. But he's still part of that despicable Culture Shock. Hearing this in an Inspire venue, it has been way too long. Going down that yellow brick road. The most popular individuals in professional wrestling today, the one and only EFFY has returned to Inspire After Death.
One half of Bussy here tonight in attendance. Three-way action you are not going to want to miss. What comes?
Still, I'm mad that you called me out for saying orgasm online, but he can say pussy and nothing?
That's the name of the tag team. And it does involve an AAPW alum in Alley Cat. So, EFFY, a former Pure Prestige champion. In fact, he defeated Ricky Stark for that title back in 2019. So great to welcome EFFY back to the ATX. And don't forget, he's getting ready to host the big gay brunch in Philadelphia in 2 weeks.
Oh, well, wrestling is gay. And the crowd tonight in Austin, Texas, here to remind us tonight.
That man's music put a smile on my face.
Always, every time.
But speaking of very nice smiles,
and another smile, because it's time for the Bornator. Toxico, you see Mel 5, KKKKK, and you see the man that will be in this match, Matt the Wrestler.
Well, EFFY and CJC may have their own ideas as to what professional wrestling may be. EFFY incredibly vocal on his own. However, Matt, well, let me put it to you bluntly, he's the wrestler. How are you going to argue what professional wrestling is with Matt the Wrestler?
That's right. And I got a feeling EFFY would fit in beautifully with the Bornator.
You know what? You might be right, honestly.
I think El Toxico needs to have a talk with EFFY.
But first, he needs to get a pink letterman, okay? He needs to, put the uniform.
No, not pink. He needs pink fishnet.
You know what? That's right.
Maybe pink fishnet.
Now you're thinking.
One of the most popular trios ever in Inspire, the Bornators. Fans absolutely love seeing these guys. Man, I feel like a woman. And please tell me we're going to get a Don Rodrigo introduction.
I think we are still.
God, I hope so. I love Richard Whitaker, but El Toxico needs the mic.
The most beautiful smile in professional wrestling.
Introducing first, representing Culture Shock, he is the Trapper, Caleb John Cartier.
Nobody likes him.
I don't think even Canada likes him.
And making his long-awaited return to Inspire, this is EFFY!
Richard knows what's coming.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Don Rodrigo. And to my right, this man doesn't believe in credit scores.
It is a social construct anyway.
He is known as Mel 5KKKKK. And to my left, I can't joke about you tonight, my friend. This man is my best friend. This man has not one but two shoulders to cry on. This man is there whenever you need him. He gives and gives and gives and never takes. He is so influential to me and my colorful friend.
Hey, yo.
This man trained more than half of the talent that you see here tonight.
It's very true. One of my trainers.
That's right. For almost a decade, while Mel and I were out getting bookings, Matt stayed. Matt stayed in AAPW and trained. He trained everybody.
He trained me.
I promise.
Hold it, wait.
He is so important. Come here. This man never gets his flowers, but he certainly plants them. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me introduce my best friend. He is known as Matt the Wrestler. And the three of us are known as the Born Haters. We are wrestling's number one mystery solving trio. And the three of us have been super busy this past month. We were hired to do an internal investigation at Nickelodeon Studios.
Oh, no. There's a mystery afoot.
Guys.
I'm not touching that with a 10-foot pole.
I'm going to be honest with you. Guys, I'm going to be honest with you. It's not looking good over there. It is very bad.
They solved the mystery.
Oh, my God.
That's right. That's not the chance I thought I would hear tonight.
Also, Brian Peck, we don't mess
now,
with him either.
It is very tricky because it was a very slimy situation. But the Born Haters, we tried to find joy and humor in things, but there is nothing to joke about the situation there. It is very hard to find humor in that. And I never thought it would be so simple. But I found a way. I found a way. But we never watched iCarly, Zoe 101, Victorious, or all the other foot-based shows. We were watching cool shit. We were watching Legends of the Hidden Temple. We were watching Nickelodeon Guts. And we were watching a lesser-known game show called Figure It Out. And let me tell you, you two cabrones, you're going to figure out something tonight. Here's what you're going to figure out. My best friend Matt is going to storm the Hidden Temple tonight. My best friend Matt is going to put together the Silver Fucking Monkey. My best friend Matt is going to grab the artifact, get out, and you two temple guards can't lay a goddamn hand on him. And he's gonna go home with the Super Nintendo or whatever the hell he wins out. And then he's going to go and storm the aggro crag. He is going to show you that he has guts. Do you have it, guts? Do you have it? He does. And let me ask you, you ugly piece of garbage. Do you have it? And let me ask you, my king slash clan. Do you have it? Oh my God.
It's a full moon in Austin.
He has it, but there's somebody who has it just a little bit more. There is somebody who has it. Do you have it? He does. And his name for the final fucking time is Matt the Wrestler!
Oh, dear Lord.
Oh, my goodness.
You never know what to expect when Don Rodrigo has the mic.
We could have an entire analysis on the comments that were just made, but
that needs to be wrong. No. Finally, this match can get underway. Three-way dance, Matt the Wrestler, CJC, and Effy.
Oh, dear Lord.
Yeah, Stu talked to us once again about the championship history of Effy, Effy's time here at Inspire AP.
Well, Effy, as I mentioned, a former Pure Prestige champion, defeated no less than Absolute Ricky Stark for that title back in 2019. Effy and Ally Catch, former GCW Tag Team Champions. Oh, good God.
Current Freelance World Tag Team Champions in the area of Chicago, Illinois.
And again, one of the most popular competitors ever to grace an Inspire ring here, especially here in Austin.
A little jaw-jacking here between Effy and CJC as both men collide. Not giving each other any ground.
Effy was telling me he has 5 matches and 3 appearances booked for WrestleMania weekend in Philadelphia in 2 weeks.
Well, definitely one of the most sought-after talents on the independent wrestling scene is Effy. And that's something that was created by his own design. Did not need a system, did not need a coach or a mentor. It was Effy and Effy alone.
Oh wow.
Effy, this is Austin, but
wait a minute.
I don't think we can show this on IWTV.
I think we
CJC,
can.
Hold on. Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Matt the Wrestler with a nice pounce.
Whoa, whoa. Hey. Matt the Wrestler's a taken man,
yeah,
okay?
Yeah, he's spoken for.
If he can't be a home wrecker.
Well, it hasn't stopped some people in the past.
Very true.
Nevertheless.
Professional wrestling. Matt the Wrestler, of course, a head trainer at AAPW. As mentioned by El Toxico Don Rodrigo, trained more than half the roster in attendance here tonight. Half the roster spending time under the tutelage of Matt the Wrestler, one of the best pure wrestlers you are going to find in our sport today.
Absolutely. Of course, Matt the Wrestler was trained at AAPW by the legendary George De La Isla.
Ah.
It was Matt the Wrestler that I first, you know, that first trained me when I walked through the, through those doors at AAPW in Pflugerville, Texas.
Did he welcome you with a hug like that?
He kind of did when you think about it.
Here's CJC. We are in our semi-main event here tonight. Still to come, main event three-way matchup. The Inspire Pro Championship.
Title ranking match.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Coming up next.
CJC very well versed in the extremities. No, my God, you see him bending the phalanges back. Oh my, normally he goes for a bite, but I don't wanna talk about what I just saw there.
Yeah, you called it there.
And now bending the elbow back at, oh! Looking to separate those tendons. CJC from Alberta, Canada, trained here in APW, but also still adopted a lot of Canadian style wrestling.
Talk about some of the best professional wrestlers to ever live, ascended from our cousins up north, so to speak. You're talking about Bret Hart. You're talking about Chris Jericho. CJC hopes to add his name to that list in the near future.
Absolutely.
Oh, my.
Canada with a fantastic.
Well.
Okay.
Well, this, CJC is known as a submission specialist.
Guess,
that is a submission attempt at least.
Oh, we're going for the purple nurples.
Uh-oh.
Meanwhile,
I think Effy wants
here comes Effy.
I think Effy wants to be a part of the menage a trois.
Effy, just.
Oh! Nobody home. Effy here.
Effy up to the middle rope.
Taking both! The wrestler and CJC out. What a blockbuster!
Effy like a house on fire. And this crowd loves it. I don't know why, but right now, Effie giving me Matt Warner vibes.
Oh, no.
I don't know why, but it just is.
Definitely a certain level of intensity being seen out of Effie here tonight, but that's nothing new. It's that same intensity that won him the Pure Prestige Championship all those years ago.
Oh, my.
Same intensity that brought him the GCW Tag Team Championship.
Look at the strength of Effy. Oh. It's very rare that you see Matt the Wrestler. Oh, manhandled so quick. Oh, my God.
Just dumped him on CJC.
Up at a cover, but a kick out of two by CJC.
You know, I think that the antics of Effy often overshadow his pure raw athleticism. The strength that Effy possesses for many people is completely off the charts, including in this three-way match.
Yeah, I think you're right. And that's in a lot of people are misled by Effie's flamboyance, shall we say. Effy is a skilled competitor inside those ropes.
Shouldn't judge a man's character based off of who they are, but how they wrestle. And well, Effy and Matt are definitely very good at their craft. Matt the Wrestler just taking it to both CJC and Effy. A multitude of splashes in the corner.
Those body splashes reminiscent of the Icon Sting.
Oh, watch this.
Athleticism hard at work. Another thing hard at work is the ring itself. Matt, oh my goodness. And senton into the splash, going for that cover, but only a kick out at two.
Matt Wrestler trying to pin both individuals at the same time?
Honestly, just imagine what it would do for his ego and for his career if he were to pin Effy. That wrestler still in full control of this match. Meanwhile. Walker, help me out.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Thrust here.
Well, you know, the age old
some ass. Creative offense, shall we say, from Effy?
No. At the end of the day, we all know what we want. This is just them wanting head.
Oh, Al Snow, help me now.
Matt the Wrestler, waist lock applied here. And German suplex takes Effy right over the top. CJC still perched on that middle rope. Watch out. Crossbody caught out by Matt the Wrestler. Look at the strength. That man is a wrestler.
Oh, the transition. Oh, into the sleeper hold by CJC. The Canadian Trapper has Matt the Wrestler dead to rights. You see Matt trying to fight out of it. And he does with a snap there. Way to create that separation.
If anyone's going to find the technical skill to battle out, it is going to be Matt the Wrestler. Can't avoid that German suplex, though.
You know, something I just noticed, Matt the Wrestler has Mel and Don Rodrigo out here. We do not see the rest of Culture Shock out here with CJC.
Oh, you're right. Danny O'Ryan celebrating a great win earlier on in the evening.
Yeah, he and Ollie Summers conspicuous by their absence.
The Trapper has Effy exactly where he wants him, trapped in the sleeper hold. Matt the Wrestler does not want to allow. Oh, no.
See Effy catching. Oh, wait. CJC, very wise, catching both men now into the sleeper hold. I think Effy shifted his weight very wisely there to break up the sleeper hold. Needs to regain composure. Oh my God, went for some sort of leapfrog, got caught.
This is the strength of Matt the Wrestler.
See him trying to fight out of it. Oh my goodness.
Almost like a leg lariat, wasn't it?
Indeed it was, going for that cover. Effy, only a kick out of two.
Yeah, going for the pin on Matt the Wrestler now. Two count.
Honestly, Effy thought he might have had it with that leg lariat, taking out both competitors, but it only resulted in a two count.
I mean, let's talk about it. Effy, it's a high-pressure situation for Effy, making a return to Inspire AD here tonight. A lot of eyes on this matchup on IWTV Live here in person in Austin, Texas, and it all comes down to this.
Oh, my God, the strength of Matt the Wrestler.
Yeah, well, and that's the thing. Matt the Wrestler, you know, is one of the strongest.
Oh, my Lord! That greetings from Toronto. Lord. CJC looking to capitalize. Oh, what a kick out of two.
I was going to say, Matt the Wrestler, one of the strongest individuals in the Inspire locker room.
Oh, leg lariat once again. Effie's down. Cover here.
Oh, wait a second.
A pinning attempt once again. Great strategy from Effy, and he got him.
Innovative victory there.
Effy!
Intentionally breaking up the pinfall attempt to swat away Matt the Wrestler, go right back into the pinfall attempt. That is veteran prowess in its textbook definition.
And that's why Effy is one of the best in the world. And Effie's calling for the microphone.
Globally, Effy has run 10 LGBTQ events with my name at the front and center. And tonight I step in the ring with two members of our community and put on a classic triple threat. And still, there are detractors to what we add to the wrestling scene. And to all of them, I say pay the fuck attention, because the gays are in control now. And we'll tell you what the fuck is happening in wrestling. And we'll tell you what the fuck is over with the people.
Wait a second.
What the hell? What?
Well, Effy laying down the law here tonight in a lawless land like Austin, Texas, but oh my God. Oh my God. Oh no, no, no.
What the hell is Brooke Savage doing out here? He's got enough enemies as it is.
Indeed he does.
Between Daylon Cavins to meet Alexandrov.
Brick is in no mood to be played with. He played for a fool.
Is he coming out for Effy?
Maybe so. If so, that's a match I definitely want to see.
Rick Savage extending his hand and Effy accepting it.
Could we see a future exhibition match between Brick and Effy? Only time can tell.
I would love to see it, if only because that means Effy comes back to Inspire.
There's no doubt about it, Stu. Effy will be back at Inspire After Death at one point or another.
It looks like it.
Effy will have an angry world breaker waiting for him when he returns. from a world breaker to a match that could shock the world here tonight. Our main event is set. Will Allday, Lil Evil, Exodus Prime, three-way main event here tonight.
Competed against one of the greatest wrestlers in the world, EFFY, tonight. You also completed CJC. He sucks balls. Everything's fine. You didn't come out on top, but you were a solid second place, and that's the win in my book, yeah? You didn't take the pin. I'm proud of you. And I'm proud of you, too. Say it. Just hug him. Don't talk.
Just
he's getting overstimulated.
Yeah, I am.
Gentlemen, we have to have a little talk about the state of things, okay? Now, I have noticed some troubling things happening here at the Inspire. People are turning on each other, and people are attacking one another, okay? And people are starting to coagulate. They're starting to form groups. They're clicking games, like something, way. They're forming trios, they're forming groups, they're forming stables, like a bunch of fucking horses. And it's scary, gentlemen. Nobody knows who to trust, and nobody knows who's going to hit them next. And so everybody's grouping up. I just have to say, I'm very happy to be proud and to be a part of you guys. But whatever is on the horizon, we have to be ready. We won't be. We have to get close. Let's get ready, Jim.
For those of you new to Inspire, whenever two or more champions meet in the ring, the titles will not change hands. It is a matter of which title ranks over the other. And I will talk more about the history of that later on as we get set for this three-way.
Match.
First, you notice the rest of Laplika, Stud Stash, and Danny B not here tonight.
I heard that Stud Stash is locked up again, so
why
it.
Does that not surprise me? Oh. Danny B, also one half of the NWA Women's World Tag Team Champion. As we get set for our second competitor, it is the undefinable champion, Will Allday.
Oh, my gosh.
Making his return to an inspiring, we have done it for Logan, but these men have history together. We'll get more on that later on. But as you see here, Will Allday hasn't been seen for quite some time. They're taking care of the commitments. It was at their last match. It was Lil Evil versus Will Allday. Lil Evil cheated to win and also injured Will Allday.
Absolutely. Will Allday, like you mentioned. These are the commitments, including championship wrestling from Hollywood, reality of wrestling, and others. As we get set for the top title holder in Inspire,
none.
It is the Blue Twin Dragon Connection Champion, Exodus Prime.
Exodus, hot, nuclear hot, honestly, because this man did the unthinkable and made the Twin Dragon Connection Blue title the top champion. He beat Lil Evil at our last show to secure that title spot in the ranking. We alluded to earlier, Steven Wolf kind of took exception to that. His partner in crime, a part of the superiority complex, kind of felt that this was supposed to be a tag team thing. But alas, Exodus Prime, well, he solidified himself as top dog in Inspire.
Right, and as we mentioned, the Twin Dragon Championships are the tag team titles, but they can be defended separately. Lil Evil shouting as he's saying that it was a fluke. I think most everybody would beg to differ.
Well, you know the age-old adage here, Stu. Two is true. Can Exodus Prime do it again and secure that title ranking as the top championship? Solidify it.
Yeah, we will see at the end of this match.
A reminder, this is a triple threat elimination match to ascertain the title rankings for Inspire AD's three biggest championships. Introducing first, the Inspire Pro Champion, Lil Evil. The undefinable champion, Mr. All Damn Day, Will Allday. And the man who holds the top belt in Inspire AD, the Blue Twin Dragon Connection Tag Team Belt, Exodus Prime.
You know, it does not matter who calls themselves the final boss, but it is more so about who proves themselves to be such. And Exodus Prime being the top dog, as you put it, well, reality is he is that final boss tonight. However, that could change by the end of this one. We're going to get into it, our main event.
Excellent analysis. I was about to mention about the whole final boss thing. You know, noted fan of Inspire programming, Dwayne Johnson, has started adopting the whole final boss name in as part of his title and whatnot. Exodus may have felt a little, you know, offended by that because, to be fair, the final boss is usually never the strongest opponent anyway. It's usually that secret unlockable boss. And, oh my goodness! Exodus proving to both Will Allday and Lil Evil he is just that.
Well, here's the reality. Will Allday and Lil Evil, these two men are going to be looking to focus on each other here. Oh, they're going to focus on everyone.
Oh, my God!
Torpe Suicida. Emphasis on the Suicida.
That was some vicious hang time there, Walker. Jesus.
I mean, they landed not 5 feet from our location right here.
And remember, it was a couple of months ago, Will Allday and Lil Evil fought in a title ranking match, Undefeatable Championship versus Inspire Championship. Lil Evil won by hook or by crook. Allday says that he cheated, and so there's a lot of bad blood between the two. Nevertheless, Allday taking it to Exodus Prime on the outside.
As I mentioned, the stipulation about title holders going after each other in a title ranking goes all the way back to 2016 when Ricky Starks, the Inspire Pro Champion, faced Keith Lee, the Pure Prestige Champion, in a title ranking match. Keith Lee was the victor that night.
Stakes are high, blood is boiling. You see Lil Evil on, calling for Will Allday.
And watch out for Lil Evil here.
Oh! Beautiful leg drop there. Taking out Lil Evil.
Exodus Prime on a mission.
Looking to end things early here. Oh! That high octane offense by Allday. Exodus following up with vicious strikes.
You run the risk in a match like this of front-loading your offense with some of your hardest and heaviest shots. Exodus Prime, Will Allday, these two men cannot risk doing so and walking away with the first elimination and heading to the showers early.
Will Allday seems to be at 100% now. We've seen matches where he has gone, oh my goodness, at 75, even 50%, even 25% full strength, and still deliver bangers and classics all across Texas and even Inspire.
You know, this situation, such a unique stipulation that you only find here at Inspire AD. It's what makes Inspire the hottest professional wrestling in the state of Texas.
You're absolutely right. And that's something, you know, although we have seen a little more often recently, after that night in 2016.
Oh my God.
The Pure Prestige title remained the top title in Inspire.
Kick out at two.
The Pure Prestige title remained the top title in Inspire until we had to take a break as the COVID-19 pandemic came about.
You see here just Lil Evil exploding on Will Allday. These two men do not like each other. Like I alluded to, Lil Evil, Will Allday, their paths have clashed before. It was Lil Evil taking the victory in their first attempt. However, goodness.
Exodus Prime just shoving Will Allday off.
Wait, holding on to that waist lock. Oh, Exodus. Oh, gets caught there.
You know, not only is a match like this so important for the three men involved, but it sets the pace for the rest of the year when it comes to the Inspire AD roster.
Oh my God.
Match like this, if championships change. Hold on, cover two. There it is. Knew it was a little too early for it to be the three.
Well, and you're right, Walker. That, you know, it definitely sets the tone for the rest of the year.
Oof.
Which title do the competitors want to go after if one is ranking over the other?
Someone might be focused on, you know, championship number one right now. Well, it might end up in the three position by the end of this night.
Absolutely.
Then you're game planning for a completely different competitor, a completely different title, style of competition. Everything comes down to this match here for the future of Inspire after death.
Prime. Oh. Took a little too long there. Got caught up by a Lil Evil. Now the biggest Mexican looking to capitalize. Oh. Gets caught.
Oh!
That rope DDT going for that cover. Kick out of two.
We've talked a lot about TV exposure. Exodus Prime recently on Ring of Honor Wrestling on Honor Club was in a four-way match with the likes of A.R. Fox and Matt Sydal.
Mm-hmm. Wait, 1 second. Exodus. Evil here, using any and every opportunity to. Oh! I was going to say, gain control!
My gosh.
You see how just quick.
That backbreaker was so vicious.
Exodus looking to end things early here. Oh my! And a beautiful counter by Lil Evil.
And the Stun Dog Millionaire there for Lil Evil. Exodus Prime underneath that bottom rope, not going to be able to make the pin yet. And it comes down to this. Will Allday.
Oh, Will Allday. Didn't take it for a ride. Oh, my God. Almost like a back suplex bomb here in Exodus.
Beautiful senton atomico from Exodus Prime.
Oh, my. And the redirection on that dropkick sends Will Allday to the outside. Oh, and look at this. Lil Evil with the roll-up. Kick out at two.
Yet to see an elimination in this matchup, but it could be coming close. It could be coming soon.
Yeah, it can come at any time, really.
Could be at the hands of Exodus Prime or Inspire Pro 80 champion.
Lil Evil looking very wobbly. At the hands of Exodus Prime.
Oh, wait a second. The dodge by Lil Evil. Beautiful show of athleticism. Oh! That's how you couldn't get one over on the final boss.
Very innovative. My. Innovative offense by Exodus Prime.
Some people would say Exodus Prime's offense is more juggling. Frowned upon in fighting tournaments as he goes, for another tope take now Allday.
And a good chunk of the audience.
Those chairs have gotten some use here tonight, not exactly by our fans in attendance. Everyone's been on the edge of their seats for this one, our main event here tonight.
That's why if you come to Inspire After Death event, you might end up being part of the action.
You saw there, Lil Evil was trying to go for that brain buster. Oh! Beautiful counter into that cutter. Oh, wait a second, gets caught. Oh my God!
And the Ushiguroshi connects for Exodus Prime, the cover here on the champion, two.
Just a two, you saw the face of Exodus Prime. He thought for sure that was a three.
You see here, Walker, maybe it might have taken a little bit more out of Exodus Prime. You see him having a little hard time, you know, recollecting himself.
Oh, you're right about that. Definitely one to focus on in that regard. But Exodus Prime has a lot in the stamina department. You have to remember that. A lot left in the tank for the final boss.
Oh. Exodus Prime trying to keep his spot.
Oh my God, what a counter by Lil Evil.
Out of midair, jackknife pin.
And Exodus Prime has been eliminated. Oh my God.
Exodus Prime has been eliminated.
So much for being on the top spot.
And a complete shift in the scenery here in Inspire AD. Exodus Prime cannot be happy about this result.
Absolutely. So now either the Inspire Pro title or the undefinable title will become the top title.
Will Allday wants to add a little bit of definition to what is considered undefinable. That definition will place Will Allday at the number one spot.
He still has to go up against the veteran in Lil Evil himself. You see him.
Oh, Lil Evil taking down the straps.
Yep, the straps have come off. Allday hammering away at Lil Evil.
Yeah, Lil Evil, Will Allday just furious blows to Lil Evil.
And, I mean, it's well earned. It was in their first excursion against each other that Lil Evil injured Will Allday months ago. He's definitely getting his lick back here. It's Will Allday, reversal. Oh!
Nice flying forearm there by Will Allday. This crowd sounding their approval.
That cartwheel. Ooh! Allday neglecting for a pinfall attempt, looking to add more punishment to Lil Evil. Needs to be careful not to overextend it. Ooh! As you see there, Lil Evil taking any and every opportunity to create that separation.
Yeah, Lil Evil, that break of the eyes. Lil Evil known to take a shortcut every now and again.
See Lil Evil there with that takedown, just hammering away at the Undefinable Champion.
The Undefinable Champion takes on the Inspire Pro Champion to close out our main event here tonight. We already know Exodus Prime placed at number 3 in the rankings. We're going to find out number 1 and number 2 shortly.
Oh, my goodness.
And it could be coming sooner or later with shots like that.
That was a solid forearm to the jaw, Will Allday.
Notice how Lil Evil doesn't do a pinfall attempt. He just wants to make sure that Will Allday stays down.
Well, and that's the mindset of Lil Evil. That's the mindset that he has permeated throughout La Clica, is punishment, punishment, punishment. Oh, good God. Spine buster by Allday.
Allday has Lil Evil. Uh-oh. Both men. Saw Evil trying. Almost looked like a rake of the eyes. Somewhat blinded Allday. Oh, wait a second. Allday, Clay Possum with a snap dragon suplex. Lil Evil.
Lil Evil looking on the verge of regaining the top spot in Inspire his title.
Both men have dug deep. But there has to be a winner. Who is going to emerge victorious? Who's going to emerge the top champion? Huge counter by Will Allday. Oh, ducks the spear. Huge curb stomp by Allday.
Hooks the leg.
Oh, what a kick out at 2.5. For a second there, Walker, I thought that Will Allday was going to become the top champion.
I thought it was going to be it, but we've yet to see who will walk away the top champion and Inspire AD.
Uh-oh, now what? What does Will Allday have in store sitting Lil Evil on that top turnbuckle?
I don't know. It's a very precarious situation for both men, as both Lil Evil and Allday hammering away at each other. Lil Evil. Oh, wait a second. Oh! That kick rung the bell of Lil Evil.
It looked like Will Allday tried for a leg scissors, and he slipped off the sweaty head.
Well, whatever that case may be, it allowed Lil Evil to capitalize with a senton, and now huge spear. Will Allday might be broken in half. He goes for the cover.
That's it.
For a second there, I thought this was over.
There's a difference between thinking and seeing, and that's what we're seeing right now. This match rolls on.
And that's the case, though. Lil Evil, when he hits that spear, it usually is over. But Will Allday still with a little bit left.
Uh-oh, Lil Evil setting Will Allday up for those patented. Oh, wait, that brain must. Oh, wait a second. Roll through. Kick out at 2. Huge super kick there by Lil Evil. Has the damage already been done? You see, Walker, both men slow to get up. What's going to happen? Who's going to take advantage of this match?
We talked early on in this match about who has the cardio advantage and what the pendulum swings whichever way. Will Allday and Lil Evil, they're both spent. And it shows right now, but Evil's just got a little bit more left in the tank. Cover here. Not even the cover.
And now Lil Evil, I think he's asking Chris Cruz for something.
Chris Cruz,
he wants a belt. He grabbed the Undefinable belt.
Oh, what about this? The insult to injury. You get your own belt hit across you. Wait a second. Well, are they dumping Lil Evil on the outside?
But watch out.
Oh, schoolboy roll up cover here off the distraction. No.
Momentary distraction there. And oh! Wait a second. Huge springboard into Guri. Will Allday take it out, Chris Cruz?
He's electric. He's electric. Will Allday's going to put this away. Will Allday's going to become the number one champion.
Good God, Will Allday up top.
Oh, wait a second. Lil Evil had the title belt in hand, but it's an autograph super kick. This could do it. Will Allday. He did it. Will Allday did it.
And your winner, Will Allday. And with that, now the Blue Twin Dragon Connection belt is number three. The Inspire belt is number two. And the number one championship in all of Inspire AD. The Undefinable Championship.
I don't believe it. The Undefinable Championship is now the top title. A title that was created out of two old former titles in the J Crown and the Exec Division now sits atop Inspire After Death.
Hard fought match between Will Allday. Wait a second, Will Allday.
Yeah, things aren't over here between Lil Evil and Will Allday. Far from it.
Far from it indeed.
Will Allday looked like he wanted to go more with Lil Evil.
Nevertheless, both men now stand at a fall of peace in their electric rivalry.
Lil Evil extending his hand. I wouldn't trust him as far as I can throw it.
Wait a second! Wait a second!
The shock.
The Pure Prestige champion hammering away at... What is going on? Pandemonium!
It's Culture Shock. Once again, running rampant. Danny O'Ryan, I guess, is pissed off that the Pure Prestige title is not number one. Culture Shock now attacking Lil Evil, Chris Cruz. Oh, good God, Danny O'Ryan has the microphone.
Everyone shut the fuck up. I left you talk for so long. Let me talk. Shut up! You guys have been talking for far too long, and I've been letting it happen for far too long. Look at me. I'm the man, not him, and not Exodus. They never have been, and they never were, and they never will be. People, you have never seen anything like me before. Breakout Superstar of the Year. Moment of the Year when I retired your oh-so-great T-Ray. Match of the Year where I once again retired your oh-so-great T-Ray.
You gotta hold me back, Walker. I'm getting upset now.
I feel it. Goddamn thing. I'm the best to ever fucking do it. Better than MJF. Better than Sammy Guevara. Better than ACH. Better than Dimitri. Better than T-Ray. And better than freaking Ricky Starks.
Whoa! Them's fighting words.
He ain't gonna do shit, and he never will to me because he can't touch me just like any other Pure Prestige champion can't fucking touch me. Let's talk.
Oh! And you can't say it isn't deserved.
Never thought I'd say this. Thank God for Lil Evil.
And now, Lil Allday doing the honors. Oh, wait a second.
Gives it to Lil Evil.
Delivers a huge brain buster to Ollie Summers.
Oh, look at Allday. Oh, my God.
Oh, my Lord. Driving the elbow.
Almost went all the way across the ring.
Whoa.
Wait a minute.
Ricky Starks.
Where did
he come from?
Austin, Texas native, Ricky Starks.
Oh my God!
With the Dominator.
Rochambeau by Ricky Starks.
You can't.
Ricky
end.
Fucking Starks is here.
You can't end it on a better walk off than that.
Ricky Starks just gave Ollie Summers the Rochambeau.
Hey, Ricky Starks, thanks for coming by my show. Thanks for stealing the thunder, Ricky. Adam, I had a bone to pick with you, and you dealt with me like a man. I got a lot of respect for you, and I think I owe you something. Maybe later.
Show respect by Will Allday and Little Evil. What
a... Thank you for holding this down while I'm gone. Now, Music Man, hit my music.
What a show tonight. Will Allday, the undefinable championship, now the number one championship in Inspire After Death. And Culture Shock got taught a lesson by no less than absolute Ricky Stark, stroke daddy of hell.
My God, what a battle, what a match. All three men, Exodus, Lil Evil, and Will Allday laid it out on the line. And it was Will Allday that stood victorious as your top champion in Inspire.
Don't forget April 28th, the return of Very Nice, Very Evil, Danhausen, right back here at the Empire Control Women Garage in downtown Austin.
I hope I don't get cursed.
Well, gentlemen, it's been a pleasure to join you here all the way from Tokyo, Japan. New Japan Pro Wrestling sent me out here, and I'm excited I had the pleasure of joining y'all for my first time at Inspire.
Roxy's LLC, you freaking idiots. I told you guys. I told you exactly what would happen. And I told you what your team was made of. You have one roided up dumbass. They have a Canadian dumbass. They have a dumbass bear, Care Bear on their team. Care Bear. And we have queen of the dumbasses, Rachel Rose, who I just disposed of. I told you exactly what would happen, and I got your head mother effing straight. Idiots.
Listen. I know I didn't win that battle royal, but I started from the beginning, and I was third to last eliminated. I busted my ass in there, like I've been busting my ass all the time. But am I mad? I'm all summers. I don't get mad, but I'm gonna get back at you. So next time, I'm not going down.
Speaking of next time, you know, this time, Effy, you might have pinned me. You might have gotten me this time. But listen, this isn't the first time a daddy's pinned me. I can get back up again, and I will. The future is looking bright for Culture Shock and CJC. Just you wait.
You've been pinned by a daddy?
Don't worry about it. Adam, I respect what you did. I respect what you did a few months ago, but guess who's back? Daddy's back. Will Allday's back. And the undefinable champion that sits on the top of the mountain where it should be, where Will Allday should be. And I had to prove it, and I have no problem proving it. And I have so much respect for Exodus. I have so much respect for you now, Adam. You took the man's way out. You didn't run, you didn't hide, you stood toe-to-toe with me, and guess what? My sights aren't on you anymore. My sights on you, Danny O'Ryan, you CJC, all the Culture Shock. And when I come back to Inspire, that bullseye's right on your back. So I don't care who they put me in the ring with, next time I'm out here, I'm gunning for you. And as for Ricky Starks, Ricky freaking Starks, thanks.
Thanks for coming back and stealing my moment. A moment that you had years ago. And now you're off. You're off to Never Never Land, and you come back for what? To steal my moment, because that's what you've always done, Ricky. That's what you've always done ever since I've known you. And guess what? Next time you're here, I'm not going to play so nice. I'm not going to talk to you on the microphone. I'm going to kick your damn head off, because my name is Will Allday, and I am Inspire AD.